Hey and welcome. My name is Tim and today I'm going to show you how to correctly insert wall elements like doors and windows into your blending and adjust them to the specifications in the floor plan. Last time we traced our floor plan complete with walls. If you haven't seen the video yet, you can watch it by clicking on the info card. The next step after tracing is to add windows and doors to our plan. To insert them, we navigate under the Start tab to the room elements. If you unfold the window, there's a section called Wall Elements. Here we can find doors, windows and other objects. If we check Enhanced Element Placement at the bottom before inserting, it is possible to place wall objects directly with the given dimensions of the floor plan. Let's insert a simple window first. By clicking on the symbol, we can now place it at the window marker in the plan. In order for the window to be exactly as shown in the floor plan, we need to make some more changes in the property editor. Here we can see a variety of different properties that we can now use to adapt our window to the real conditions. For example, we see that the window needs to be moved slightly towards to the outer wall. To do this, the center offset must be adjusted. Here I enter a value of 6 cm. If it happens that the window contains several segments, we don't have to insert them one by one. We can directly define the numbers of segments here. If necessary, it is also possible to insert the window with a rounding or to make further adjustments, for example, to the windowsills. The next step is now to insert the doors. Here in the floor plan, it is easy to see where the doors need to be placed and in which direction they can be opened. Now let's insert our first door. As with the window, we first set the width of the door based on the dimensions on the floor plan and can now directly define the opening angle of the door. That's easy, isn't it? In addition, it is also possible to add further configurations, such as a fan light, or as in this case, to make it a double door. In this floor plan, we still need some glass fronts. These are also found with the wall elements and can be inserted just as easily. As with the windows, the glass fronts are slightly offset to the outside. This can be solved again with the center offset. The bars of the glass fronts can also easily be adapted to the floor plan. With a click on the blue line, we can move the position to the right place. If there are too many bars, they can be deleted by clicking on the delete key on the keyboard. In this way, all other wall objects can be inserted into the plan and adjusted with the property editor. Now our floor plan is complete and ready to be outfitted with textures and furniture. If you have any questions about this topic, feel free to write us a comment below the video. Subscribe to our channel for more videos about all Peacon products. Thanks for the attention and see you next time.